All right, hey Scorpio. So I'm doing a read for you guys, and this is to help call in love. And we're gonna explore the conscious and subconscious fears and see what we can do to help unblock that energy so that you can call in love, self-love, or just healing in your relationships. All right, so you're gonna know this is your read by your energy and how you feel about love. So let me get that first. So your current energy, quite hanging in the balance. You got the hanging man card coming through. So maybe uncertainty when it comes to love. You got the sun card flipped over in reverse. So some of you guys could be in a less than desirable energy, and it could be due in part to a specific person. All right. When it comes to your energy, though, like the hanging man card coming through with the emperor, it's almost like you are lacking getting a certain person to kind of come forward. The sun card in reverse is going to be the apparent reversal of the happily ever after. So the happily ever after isn't coming through. Questioning, is it an illusion? Is this all a delusion? Like, are my feelings are real when it comes to this? But what I also see right here is the majority of you kind of going through and balancing your own divine masculine energy, whether you're male or female, it does not matter. But balance is coming through because you do want happiness, and you're not going to let a person either promote or demote your own happiness. And with the hangman card, it's just, I feel like this energy could be in the background or a back thought. Maybe what you're seeing or what you felt with this energy is just, it's not real. The Empress and the Emperor showing up here. So some of you guys are on a big journey. So let's see how it is you feel about love. How do you feel? So you're very conflicted. It's like you want a new beginning, but you're definitely not putting yourself out there when it comes to love, and it could be because of a specific situation or person. With the Hermit card coming through, this is all just it's going within. It's being analytical. It's being thoughtful, and I really feel like you're just kind of just going through and channeling your feelings and your emotions when it comes to love. All right, with the Five of Wands coming through here, it's like I definitely do not want drama. I don't want chaos. I don't want to be strung along. I want the real deal. And you're not just putting yourself out there to get attention or to get anybody right now. You're just really focused on your own spiritual, aspects, your own journey, whether it's spiritual or not. I just feel you're not putting yourself out there, but you do desire that new beginning. So I'm going to pull to see what your conscious fears are. This is energy that you're aware of. All right. So this is what you know. So conscious fears. So with flirt card coming through, what I'm going to say, extend your lighthearted energy to others. It's almost like you guys could be afraid, especially if you have somebody really, really strong penetrating your energy. You're afraid to put yourself out there. All right. And it could be because this one person that you're holding near and dear to your heart might come back and kind of impede on something new if you were to create it, right? With flirt card too, it could just be that you're not feeling top of your game, or there's a little bit of self-confidence or self-esteem coming through here that needs to be worked through. All right. And we have let your friends help you, ask for and accept support from others. Okay, with the let your friends help you, with this card coming through, you guys, some of you could have friends that are trying to hook you up or help you. Coworkers, family, with this card coming through, it could just be that you got people saying, "Hey, I got this person I want you to meet. Hey, I got this going on." It could be too that you just don't want to put yourself in the middle or get involved with somebody who is a part of your group, a part of your soul tribe, a part of your friendship, because you know how it is when feelings get involved here. And it could be too that people are just really kind of putting the pressure on you, and you don't feel like that. You don't feel like you want to entertain it, and we have true love coming through. And with this being a conscious fear, I'm almost feeling like you guys feel that this is that's where the illusion, the uncertainty, the delusion is coming through. Does it really exist? How come people don't think like me? How come there is no energetic matches out there for me? With true love, with the hangman, it's also kind of like given into the illusion. It's not true. It would happen, right? It would have already happened. So with that kind of being said, you guys, those fears, this is what you're going to want to kind of release. We have the full moon coming through. And so in this design right here, if there's been situations where flirting has failed, friendships and introductions have failed, and you know, you've experienced a true love dynamic and it's failed, that is energy that you want to let go of. You're going to heal it by forgiving the energy, the people, the situation, forgiving that, and then forgiving yourself for holding on to it. And in turn, if you've inflicted any of this yourself, you're going to want to forgive yourself for creating that and healing that within you. So let's see what you're not seeing. This is going to be your subconscious fears. Okay. So with the subconscious, we got bride in a cage. Okay, and with this right here, you know, this right here is talking about relationships, maybe in the past that have just kind of nailed you back. Maybe felt like you had to walk around with your head down. You couldn't look at people. You couldn't talk to people. This is feeling really trapped, okay? And you're gonna think about the relationship, the person that's coming through here that made you feel this way. And this could be something that you haven't wanted to think about, haven't wanted to bring up. You know, this right here, it could be something as light as always the bridesmaid, never the bride. I can identify with this card being a Scorpio and this card showing up, guys, because I've been a bridesmaid several times and have not been married once. Okay. But just kind of think about the energies and what you're holding on to. And even if there's nobody that you can put to this, say you felt like you've just never been good enough. You're always the one second cast, right? So what you're going to do with that healing dynamic is come through and say, no, I am receiving the love of a lifetime. I deserve the love of a lifetime. I deserve to be on the forefront. I deserve to have my energetic match come through. And you know, if somebody has felt like, you know, if you felt like somebody has trapped you in the past, codependent, gaslighting, narcissism, manipulation, you're gonna dig deep. Write that person a letter and forgive them. You do not owe anyone a relationship or verbal apology. As long as it's done within your heart, you guys, that's the truest form of forgiveness that comes through there. And you know, if you can't think of who this might be, set intentions before bed, pray, ask for the person to come through your dreams so that you can get you know, a jump on what it is that you're trying to heal. We have sacrifice coming through, all right? And this subconscious energy right here of sacrifice is possibly, why isn't there an inner, why do people screw with me? Why are people, you know, not in alignment with my, how I think? Why can't I find somebody that puts the same effort, time, and energy into me as I do them? You guys, with this card, this might not even be subconscious. It just might be that you don't let it bother you and it's still in your subconscious. You're still feeling like, it's almost like I feel like you're thinking deep down inside somewhere, maybe you're not good enough, but what you need to do is turn that thought around that maybe you're too good for some of the energies that you've poured into, especially when they're not pouring back in the same manner. And then we have downcast pride coming through here, all right, as a subconscious block. What I'm gonna say with this card, Scorpio, is you guys could have dealt or had somebody that you felt really, really drawn to, really attracted to. You really had a very special place in your heart for this person, but due to this person being a single parent with kids and what people are gonna say, due to their religious aspects and what people are gonna say, due to what just, I'm almost saying, think about the most shallowest part of your ego and somebody that you could have had this interaction with, okay? And I feel that it's safe to say we've all been guilty of kind of denying somebody, you know, because they were missing a tooth in the front. You know, I don't know. But this right here to me is just, it's saying, you know, the superficial and the shallow aspects, kind of going back through your own personal inventory and where have you kind of placed that downcast pride on other people? You know, even if you're not like that anymore, there could be a situation with a person in the past that you've kind of pushed down in such a way that you've completely forgotten about that, right? So with that being said, let's just see what happens. Your advice to kind of go through and really unblock all of this. Your advice to help you unblock. So it's kind of thinking into the future with a positive mindset, you guys. All right, so here's what we got. So you got the Six of Cups coming through. This is healing the past, and I feel like this card is going to reference when you were young, immature, when you were kids. Think deep about the past, okay, when it comes to the situations, conscious and unconscious, okay? You know, I just feel like this is a deep healing that comes with, you know, childhood or the immature phases of life. You know, we have the Four of Wands coming through here as happiness, hope for the future, marriage, commitment, celebrations, and really kind of settling down. All right. And if you guys are dealing with somebody currently that feels really like a deep person that's supposed to be here, I feel, you know, on the deeper journeys, you know, spirit's just kind of reminding you there's a lot that needs to be done before we can align, you guys. But you know what? Not to worry. Your ships are coming in. You guys have a beautiful life ahead of you coming through. But it's just time to dig down. It's time to dig down and clear all the negative energy that's still kind of riding with you. All right. And your next 3 months, we're going to see after you guys do these unblocks and healing what's coming in the next 3 months. All right. So some of you guys here, look at what we got. We have faith coming through. All right. This is like the Hierophant. This is order. It's rules. You have the Moon card coming through just as well. So light at the end of the tunnel. Something big is going to be unveiled here. And Spirit's also kind of reminding you guys, do not waver in what you know to be right. Stay true to your heart, especially if you feel really strong. If you're in a connection right now, it's like, don't worry. In time, everything will be good. But this is all stuff that needs to be healed through. All right. Next 3 months coming out of the cold. You know, you got also the Three of Swords coming out of heartbreak, feeling loneliness, feelings of rejection. You guys are coming through that. So, you know, it might not be the most brightest day coming through, but I do feel with the Moon card, just something big is going to be unveiled for you guys. So I'm going to leave it there. Scorpio, take care.